that important vitamin C for your color, your character, and your colon. Why don't you buy a bunch today? Well, tomorrow then, because stores have just closed since it's 5 o'clock on the big CBC clock on a chilly Monday afternoon, December 1st. Just 23 days away from the big Christmas broadcast of 1941. And now, stay tuned for the adventures of that masked rider of the plains, the Lone Ranger.
Fiery horse with the speed of light, a cloud of dust, and a hearty Hi-Yo Silver, the Lone Ranger.
I'm in a school day, and I'm listening
to the
here. Oh, no, you're not.
Oh, no, you're not.
Stop that noise! Now. What is going on?
Mickey's determined to hog the radio when I've been working all day, and all I want to do is relax and listen to Bing.
Who wants to listen to that stupid singer who sings all about that mushy stuff? Without you, ba 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 boo.
Yeah, well, who wants to listen to a stupid cowboy without a name?
He does, too.
I'll tell you who's going to listen to the radio. Nobody, if this racket keeps up. Time for the news, anyway.
These are the inhabitants of apartment 2C, 801 Nutwood Avenue, San Francisco, California, U.S. of A. My name's Howard West. I've been living with this colorful group of folks around me since my wife Amy died of typhus during the Great War. Now, we call that the war to end all wars, but I got a feeling what's going on over in Europe is going to give that one a run for its money. Now, that woman who just flew in here from the kitchen, that's my daughter, Norma. Her husband, Pete, he's a pilot and an aircraft mechanic. He volunteered to go work on those aeroplane parts we've been sending overseas to the Allied forces since March of this year. He's been at that air base for about 5 months now, so Norma's certainly had her hands full taking care of all of us. Yeah, she's sure had her hands full. Especially with my grandson, Mickey. He always seems to have his fingers into something around here. Every time I see a frog or a broken window or a slingshot, I think of this fella right here. And then here's her teenage daughter, Angie. Kind-hearted, good-natured, doesn't know how pretty she is yet. She works in a bookstore. What she really wants is some real-life romance in her life. Well, that's the family. There always seems to be a couple of neighbors hanging around, and they... Yeah, that's Sid. Sid! Sid's a retired used car salesman who lives downstairs. He spends all his free time torturing that poor violin and torturing us right along with it. Then we... Oh, hear that? That's Lil. Lil! Lil! Now, Lil is our... Feisty one, she is. Lil is our building maintenance supervisor. She took over that job about 8 years ago when her husband died. That woman does things with a pipe wrench others have only dreamed about. Oh, she's a peach. She's a keeper. Oh, I need to mention Danny, our mailman. I think what he'd really like is some of Angie's romance. He thinks she's a swell. Kids today and their wild talk. I don't get it, but anyway. Now, I think now is a good time for us to go hear that news that Norma is so all fired anxious to listen to.
And this was just handed to me. The British casualties continue to mount in the Mediterranean as another carrier is attacked. Hitler's armies under the command of General Bach appear to be in their final drive toward Moscow. President Roosevelt today restated his intention to continue the shipment of arms to England in agreement with the amendment to the Neutrality Act.
Listen to some shootouts and brawls. It's less violent than the news.
Thank you, my faithful companion.
Smokey Ballard and Joe turned in the saddle. They saw the masked man followed by a hard-riding Indian and Sheriff Alder.
They're after us.
Get him!
As the thieves drew guns to fire, the Lone Ranger's Colts roared. bullet in the arm nearly threw Joe from the saddle, while Smokey pulled his racing horse to a rearing halt in an effort to fire accurately. But the Lone Ranger fired first.
Turn that infernal noise down.
I'll go after his pal. Come on, Billy!
What's wrong with you, Angie?
Ugh. Nothing ever happens around here. It's so boring. I don't have any romance or any adventure in my life. It's only on the radio.
Well, you never know. Sometimes romance and adventure are right in front of you and you don't even realize it.
Come on, Gramps. Do you really expect me to believe that one day the doorbell's gonna ring and out of the blue into my drab little life is gonna walk romance and adventure? I don't think so. Oh.
Mail delivery.
You never know.
Hi, Danny.
Package! Bet it's a Christmas present. Is it for me?
Please? Is that the doorbell? Is it? Oh, it's just you, Danny. Is it a telegram?
No, it's a delivery for Angie.
Oh. This is addressed to a Mrs. Lillian Reinwald in number 2A.
It is? How did I make a mistake like that?
I wouldn't venture a guess.
Gee, Danny, it seems like you bring us wrong mail every day.
Mickey, why don't you run and tell Lil we have a package for her, please? And I'll go check the roast.
I guess I must need glasses or something.
Somebody needs something around here.
Danny, you wear glasses already.
I do. I do. Things just slipped my mind.
I didn't say nothing. I'm hungry.
I ran into the Lone Ranger out here in the hall. Heard there's a package for me.
Oh, right here. Sorry, I brought it to the wrong apartment.
He's got a slip mind.
Lil, what happened to you? You're all wet.
Yeah, there's two small leaks in the plumbing in the basement. This could be the problem.
My pipes?
By the way, I wouldn't try taking a shower for a while. Sorry, Sid. Hot water in 30 minutes. Keep your drains clear. Bye.
Mickey, you have 5 minutes until dinner to finish that homework.
All right. Sure wish that package had been for me.
Hey, Mickey, come here. What do you want for Christmas anyway?
I want to be a hero, like the Lone Ranger, or the Green Hornet, or the Shadow, and fight the bad guys and win.
Oh, well, why don't you think of your arithmetic as being one of those bad guys and go finish him off?
I'd better be going, too. It's the kitchen.
Make a note of that, Angie. That's the kitchen.
Bye, Mr. West. Bye, Angie.
See you tomorrow, Danny. About 5.
Still 5 minutes left of the Bing Crosby show.
Say, Angie, what is it you want for Christmas anyway?
I don't know, Grandma.
Every month of May, sunny skies.
Guess it's slipped your mind.
All the way as the sun peeps through. May express happiness. Joy you may define in a thousand ways. But a case like mine needs a special phrase to reveal how I feel.
That is the stupidest song I have ever heard.
Oh, Gramps. Just because you don't remember what it's like to be young and in love.
I remember both of those things very well, thank you. What I'm having a hard time remembering is songs that were not written for audiences with the IQ of spam.
Love is a lot more than moons and Junes, honey.
No. That's the part that just seems the best, don't you think?
No. The part of love that's the best is whatever lasts through the Junes and moons. Through all those tough times. That's the love worth hanging on to.
Life is a beautiful thing.
Ready for dinner?
Yeah.
As long as I hold the string.
Well, it looks like my two girls want the same thing for Christmas.
You do, Mom? You want a rhinestone snood, too?
Rhinestone diamond.
rhinestone snood? No. No. Take it from me. They really do want the same thing for Christmas. Suppose we all do. Just peace on earth again and to be with the ones you love. It's funny how prayers and dreams at Christmas are often one and the same.
Dad, dinner.
Coming. I'll just turn the radio up while we eat again. Just 23 more days till Christmas. Can't wait to hear who's on tonight.
Oh, what a world, what a life. I'm in love. Lucky me, can't you see that I'm in love? Life.
December 3rd, as we listen to the chilling conclusion of tonight's adventure of The Shadow.
Who knows what evil lurks in the hearts of men? The Shadow knows.
The plot murder announced for today has been postponed. Today, the Circle of Death.
Oh, Jack, what a delightful show. What a wonderful way to start our honeymoon.
Darling, when it comes to shows and girls, I'm a swell picker. Now watch me pick a nightclub.
Oh, taxi! Hey, taxi!
Darling, I think you're wonderful. I've never had such a marvelous time in my life.
Hop in, honey.
Who is it? Who's there? Norma, is that you? I was just about ready to kiss an angel. What are you trying to do? You give me a heart attack?
I'm sorry, Dad. Still working on that turkey leg, huh?
No, we can finally pronounce last rites on this guy. Say, what are you doing down here at this hour anyway?
Praying?
With the Shadow?
All right. The Shadow was Pete's favorite radio show. He never misses an episode, and I just wanted to keep up with the story so I could tell him when he comes home.
Oh, now listen, you're not starting to get worried that Pete might not come home now, are you?
Dad, I don't know what to think of the world anymore. It's turned so upside down.
Well, I guess that's so. That's why we're mighty lucky to have the Lord right in the middle of things to help us keep our balance.
Is the Lord in the middle of it all? I don't see where, because nothing's turning out the way I thought it would.
Well, we don't often get much say about how things turn out. That's someone else's job.
Mom's Bible.
Turn up the light, would you? I can barely make out the words.
So old and faded, you could hardly read it anymore.
Yep. This Bible saw more action in the last war than the Battle of Verdun. Suppose I should probably get a new one, but no matter. I know it by heart anyway. Your mother used to quote it to me all the time. For consider that the suffering of this present time is not worthy to be compared to the glory that will be revealed in us.
I really miss Mom sometimes.
Well, I miss her too, all the time.
Oh, Dad, what could be worse than spending Christmas alone?
Well, when you find out, you be sure and tell me. You know, this is the 24th Christmas I've spent without the woman I planned on spending every Christmas with. Every time I think I put it all behind me, I see something. Azaleas under the kitchen window. A pair of slippers the dog had chewed. The white handkerchief she always uses a bookmark, and it all just comes flooding back to me. Sounds and feelings. Remember we used to cuddle up here on the sofa? She'd start singing Christmas carols in that slightly off-key voice of hers. Silent night. She could never get that second note right. Holy. Oh, she left too soon. She never got to teach that song to Angie or Mickey, and now they've gone and learned it on their own. With the right notes. Well, it's still not easy, but it has gotten better. I was a tough pupil, but the Lord's managed to teach me a thing or two over the years, and I think when someone we love leaves our world, I think it helps at Christmas time to think that we're celebrating someone coming into our world. Without him, I don't think I would have made it. Well, I'm going back to bed. You coming, sweetheart?
No, I think I'll just sit by myself for a while. Well, not really by myself.
No, not by yourself. Good night, Princess.
Good night, Daddy.
I'll be home for Christmas. You can count on me. Please have snow and mistletoe and presents on the tree. Christmas Eve will find me where the love light gleams. I'll be home for Christmas. If only
wake up, America. It's 9 a.m. on Thursday, December 4th, and the makers of Gillette Shaving Cream will be bringing you Buddy Burfein's Sports Heroes Scrapbook. Today, we bring you the story of quarterback Buck Schreiber. But first, a word from our sponsor.
Buck Schreiber, my kidney blaster. He was nothing compared to Howard the Slingshot West, third string quarterback of the almost champion Altoona, Kansas, screaming kangaroos. Woo! Well, I'll tell you what, we would have won it if it wasn't for Butterfingers McNabb. That was back in 1903, and I... See it! Take 10, it's game time!
Buck Schreiber. He was a lean, shy kid from Kentucky.
I was lean too, but scrappy.
No one ever paid attention to him until he got a pigskin in his hand. The first time he played, he was the substitute quarterback in Princeton's big game against Duke. On the third play, Buck took the snap, then faded back to the left.
I'm fading. Give me some blocking.
Long look to the right. He pumps once. Pumps twice.
Where's my receiver?
Dombrowski, the pile driver, breaks his double team.
Forget my receiver. Where's my blocking?
Buck by the jersey. He's going down and lets one fly.
Hello? It's a bomb!
He's found Sam in the street.
Is this yours, Mr. West?
Thanks, Sammy. I mean, Danny. A pretty good set of hands you got there, son.
Thanks.
Was that the doorbell I heard? Is it a telegram?
No, it's just Red Grange.
No, it's not. It's Danny Thompson. I have it delivered for Angie.
Who should I call to come get their package?
No, this is for Angie.
I'll be. It is for Angie.
I know that for a fact because... Well, because I sent it. I figured it was time that I fessed up and told her how I really felt. So I'm mailing her a package.
I'm sure she'll get the message.
We interrupt this broadcast to bring you a special news bulletin. The AP wire services have just reported the German offensive in Russia has been defeated. Hitler's armies have suffered heavy losses and have been driven out of Moscow by Marshal Zhukov. We will keep you updated on further developments. And now, we return you to our regular program.
Please God, this terrible war is ending!
Hitler's defeated!
Pete will be home!
Well, now wait a minute, it's just one battle.
No, the Lord is in the middle of this, I'm sure of it!
Well, I pray that you're right, sweetheart.
Sunday morning, December 7th, 1941, the Continental Broadcasting Company is honored to bring you our morning worship service. We're broadcasting live this morning from friendly First Baptist Church, Coffeyville, Kansas, featuring the inspirational Reverend Glenn Muncy, along with the sanctuary choir, accompanied by Thelma Schwegler on the organ. Let's join them now in their opening hymn.
65 years old and I've been grounded. One little chest cold and I've been banished from God's temple. Everybody else traipses off to church and I'm confined to worship over the airwaves. Oh, I'll worship, but I will not sing along with Thelma. I've got water pipes that sound better than that. Thanks to Lil.
Is that all?
Oh my goodness, no. I wear trousers too.
Any other interest in aviation, Mr. Wimple?
Well, sometimes I wet my finger and hold it up to see which way the wind is blowing, like aviators do.
Oh, I always thought they threw a handful of grass up in the air.
No. Real airplane pilots look for a herd of cows.
They do?
Yeah. Cows always stand with their tails to the wind. Pilots always look for that. They like a tailwind.
Come on, you listen to me as well. You have misbehaved in church one too many times. No radio for a week. Don't you go taking his side.
Whose side? I don't know what's going on.
Why is it that everyone in this apartment building, everyone, knows more about my life than I do? There's no privacy around here.
As the plane moves through the air...
Dad, I can't believe this.
As it passes across the wing...
I told you to listen to the church service.
You told me to feel better, so I was.
It's the Lord's day.
It's also the day of rest.
You're not listening.
You won't let me.
As long as you two can't decide, I'm going to listen to my favorite station.
Sid!
What? What's wrong with your record? I can hear you all the way through.
Well, now wait, I was sick, man. I'm just trying to lose weight.
There has been a surprise attack on our naval bases at Pearl Harbor, Hawaii by Japan. A report has just come in that over 300 bombers have opened fire on the battleships and destroyers of the American Pacific fleet harbored there. The first reports indicate that the USS Arizona is completely destroyed. The Oklahoma is capsized and the Nevada is beached. Other battleships are reported on fire. Early casualties are estimated at over 1,000, with more anticipated as the attack continues. It is not known if the Japanese are confining this act of war to Pearl Harbor, or if this is the beginning of an offensive on the continental United States. All air bases in California and Oregon are on emergency alert. Regular programming of the Continental Broadcasting Company is preempted until further notice.
Oh, come, all ye faithful, joyful and triumphant. Oh, come ye to Bethlehem.
It has been over 36 hours since Japan's attack on Pearl Harbor. Our latest bulletin puts the death toll at over 2,600 servicemen and 60 civilians. We have just received reports that the Japanese have attacked Hong Kong, the Philippines, Guam, and Wake Island. The West Coast is asked to keep their lights off again tonight. Meanwhile, in the European theater, German...
Enough for a while. Sometimes I think we spend too much time listening to the world and not enough time listening to God.
Sometimes the world makes it awfully hard to hear God.
Well, that's true.
Grandpa, what's going to happen now?
Well, I don't know, Mickey. Are you scared?
No. Yes.
Well, me too.
I don't even know who the bad guys are anymore. Who are we fighting, Grandpa?
Well, we're fighting the bad side of people, all people. It's called sin. But you know what? That fight's already been won. Jesus did that for us. He did it for all of us. Germans, Japanese, Americans, all of us. Okay?
No, stay put. I'll get it.
What time is it?
It's 7 o'clock in the evening.
Danny, what are you doing here?
I have a telegram. It's from the War Department.
It's Pete. He's all right. His airbase was just taken off alert. He's flying out tomorrow. He's already joined up. He's going directly to the Solomon Islands.
I've joined up too.
What?
I won't be leaving for a few days, and I don't even know I'll be going yet. But I know it's what I'm supposed to do.
How do you know it's what you're supposed to do? How does anybody know what they're supposed to do anymore?
Didn't you get the package I brought?
Oh, I'm sorry, Angie, we forgot. Danny brought this in last Thursday.
Bible.
I've often heard you talk about what a strong woman your mother was, how she taught you about God working through all things, and I know how much your Bible meant to you all, but I understand the words have gotten awfully hard to read. I guess I thought that this might be a time when it would be important to have those words clear and very easy to read. Oh, come visit before I leave, Angie.
We'll be praying for you, son.
That's right.
Yeah, we all will.
Thank you. That means a lot. Goodbye, Angie.
What's happening to our world? Why is God letting this happen?
Oh, now, Angie, honey. God didn't give us any easy answers when it comes to things like war and death. What he gave us was himself.
I know, Gramps, but it's just so hard to watch all your hopes and dreams fall apart right in front of you.
Oh, honey. know, sometimes God is for dreams, and I think he usually is, but sometimes they're his dreams, not ours. You know, Bethlehem was a lot like our world is tonight. It was dark and filled with armies and ruled by a dictator, real fearful and uncertain future. Those people had hopes and dreams too. They'd been waiting a long time, 2,000 years, okay? Now God answered their dreams, but not in the way they expected. Not with a ruler or another army, but with a little baby. Okay. You know, when the shepherds and kings looked at that Christ child, they didn't understand everything. But they had the faith to believe that God's plan was bigger than theirs.
I guess you could say that sometimes your dream doesn't come true, so that God can make a bigger dream come true for everybody.
Sometimes it takes a while to realize that.
Sometimes it takes a while.
Listen, they're broadcasting it again.
A date which will live in infamy. The United States of America was suddenly and deliberately attacked by naval and air forces of the Empire of Japan. The attack yesterday on the Hawaiian Islands has caused severe damage to American naval and military forces. I regret to tell you that very many American lives have been lost. In addition, American ships have been reported torpedoed on the high seas between San Francisco and Honolulu. I believe that I interpret the will of the Congress and of the people when I assert that we will not only defend ourselves to the uttermost, but will make it very certain that this form of treachery shall never again endanger us. With confidence in our armed forces, with the unbounding determination of our people, we will gain the inevitable triumph, so help us God.
Looks like we won't be having a big Christmas broadcast this year after all, huh, Grandpa?
Well, it looks like that, Mickey, but that's just another thing we'll put on the list to wait for God's timing on, right?
Grandpa, look what's going on out in the street.
Well, would you look at that? Have you ever seen so many lights?
It's the Smiths and the Davies and the Gardeners. It's half the neighborhood.
No, it's the entire neighborhood. What are they doing with those lights? Didn't someone tell them there's still a blackout tonight?
Well, I'm sure someone did tell them. But they're listening to someone else, and so are we.
Thank you. song broke forth, and jamming strained, and none could help but sing the
by a vision,
shining angel.
Jesus had wanted for any reason, a star in the sky or a bird on the wing, or all of God's angels in heaven for to see, he surely could have asked.
He was the king. Thank you. darkness, pour over me your holiness, for you are holy. Breath of heaven, hold me together, be forever near me. Breath of heaven.
Did you know that your baby boy would one day walk on water? Mary, did you know that your baby boy would save our sons and daughters? Did you know that your baby boy has come to make you new? This child that you've delivered will soon deliver you. Mary, did you know that your baby boy will give sight to a blind man? Mary, did you know that your baby boy will calm a storm with his hand? Did you know your baby boy has walked where angels trod? And when you kiss your little baby, you've kissed the face of God. Oh, Mary, did you know? Mary, did you
strangers, they home so far
Salvation inside a willing girl, and it becomes God in the flesh, a baby.
The angels sang glory to God, and the shepherds and wise men bowed before their Savior.
This child lying in the stable means God has done the impossible for us. He has come to earth to save you and me.
In the city of David, the city.
this faltering tongue would dare to speak of thee, my Lord, of one so weak. I must not keep from thee.
Against bone. Blood seeps from wrist wounds and splatters on the ground. The man gasps for breath, his ribcage heaving against gravity. Spike-split feet fight for leverage against splintered wood. Cartilage rips, and new blood traces the wooden whorls of the cross. A rasping cry rattles the darkening sky. It is finished. The man's thorn-embedded head sags against his whip-scarred chest, no longer fighting the weight of the world's sin. The earth shakes. A soldier stabs the sin-drenched corpse with a spear. Blood and water drain from heart and suffocated lungs, streaming down the spear and over the soldier's calloused, dirt-encrusted hands. It is indeed finished.
Lady, me, You're here tonight, and it's the 32nd year in a row, by the grace of God, that we've had the privilege to present the Living Christmas Tree to our community and friends, to tell them about this wonderful God who came into this world to give us hope and to give us life. You know, the play that we saw earlier this evening was written by a woman named Craig Clare. And she wrote this the Christmas of 1990, just a few months away from the war that we entered into with Iraq, which has been popularized as Desert Storm. And she wrote this as the country sort of waited with just anticipation to see what would happen. And she wrote this kind of as her response to some of those feelings that she had. And how ironic that we stand here tonight about 7 years later, and we have just concluded Desert Fox, and the aftermath of that now follows, and only God knows what lies ahead. But tonight, we aren't here to challenge one another politically, but our hope and prayer is that we would challenge one another spiritually about the issues of life that really do count, and getting beyond kind of the news and the weather and the sports, and talk about the things that really are at the heart of the issue that God came into the world to give us opportunity to look at and think about. The Bible tells us that God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. Describes a wonderful love that God has for us. But there's also a problem as we look at Scripture a little bit further, and the problem is this. The Bible describes the fact that man is over here and God is over here, and there's a large gap, a large separation between both man and God. The Bible tells us in the book of Romans, for all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. Our attempts to kind of bridge that gap between ourselves and God, all of us have tried different things. I know I have over the years. And many of us have tried in our attempts to reach God and to know Him personally and to have that peace in our hearts that we too will spend eternity with God in heaven one day, is that maybe we've tried things like morality. We've tried to be good. And there's nothing wrong with that, but God says that even falls short of my glory. Many of us have tried giving to charitable organizations, hoping that that will be good enough. A lot of us have spent a lot of time going to church or visiting churches, and religion has been a part of our efforts to reach God. And the Word of God is very clear and says that although all these things may be good things, they are not what God is looking for. We still fall short of God's perfect plan that He's given to us. And so that presents the problem. But God in His love for us provided a remedy. And that remedy was the cross. The cross that the Son of God, Jesus Christ, died upon for my sins, for your sins, for all of our sins. He did it voluntarily because He was compelled by a deep love for us, knowing all about us, knowing what's in our hearts, and He still chose to die for me and to die for you. This is the wonderful love which the Living Christmas Tree for 32 years has tried to demonstrate and tried to show in a very simplistic way, the gospel message that God came into this world to give us hope, to give us life. For Christ also suffered once for our sins, the just for the unjust, that He might bring us to God, Scripture tells us. And so, there is no other way to heaven. There is no other way to receive this free gift of eternal life except by bowing our knee, submitting our will, and turning our lives over voluntarily to God's Son, Jesus Christ, and accepting this free gift of God becoming like us, like man, incarnate, receiving that free gift, and asking God to forgive us, come into our lives, and to make us a new creation. You know, God's at work in this ministry here at First Baptist Church of Downey. We see life after life after life change, from our children and teenagers on up through our adults and seniors. And it's evident to us that God is at work, not because of what we're doing, but because of what God has already done. And Christ said that we can become new creatures in Christ. We can become a new creation. And if you're frustrated tonight, or if you came in tonight and your life just feels like it's in shambles, it's out of control, and you can identify with some of the people that were in the play tonight, and you know that you've tried just about everything, and now you're saying possibly to yourself tonight, why not try God? We invite you tonight to say a simple prayer, and the prayer will just state that you're going to ask Christ to forgive you of your sins and to come into your life and to make you a new creation. And as I lead out in that prayer this evening, I would invite you tonight, if that's something that you really would want to do, I invite you to pray along with me and to mean it with all of your heart, to mean it with everything that is within you, and at that point to see what God will take from this night and what He will begin to do. And it will be something in which you will be glad for. As we bow our heads right now, I'm going to ask that you would just join me in a moment of prayer. And I'm going to say a simple prayer. And if God is speaking to your heart tonight and kind of prompting you and just you sense that there's something you need to do tonight in terms of this decision for Christ, I invite you to do it with me. Let's bow in prayer. Lord Jesus, we thank You for a great night. And God, there's many here this evening. Thank You, God, that You know what's upon the hearts of each one of us. And Father, tonight, if there is someone here or several here who really want to do business with You, I pray that You will hear the desires of their heart right now as they repeat after me. Lord Jesus, thank You for dying on the cross for my sins. I invite you into my life. Forgive me. Make me a new creation. Begin that work right now. God, thank you for giving me the gift of eternal life. Help me now to live my life for you. Show me where I go from this point. And help me to show by my actions that the decision I've made tonight is from my heart. God, I'm tired of trying to save myself and to be good enough. I rest tonight in the fact that you paid the price for my sins. Thank you for coming into my life, for giving me a new relationship with you, and for the gift of eternal life. I praise you. In Jesus' name, amen. Life's most important decision. And we thank you for your attentiveness tonight. As I close off, I'm going to invite you to take this card that you received as you walked in tonight. It's the Living Christmas Tree 98, kind of a comment card. And we invite you now to just kind of finish completing that. And you may want to respond to the message tonight or any decision or decisions that you've made tonight. We would love for you to mark that. And then as you leave in just a few moments, to take that card and just place it face down on your seat. And we'll collect those a little bit later. We'd love to pray for you and resource you and help you in discovering what this new life is all about. And if we can care for you in any way, that will help us to do that as well. As you make your way out tonight in just another moment or two, our ushers will be standing back there, and they would like to pass along some information about friendly and caring and strategic First Baptist Church of Downey, if you would be interested in receiving some. And also, if you would like to give financially to the ongoing ministry of the Living Christmas Tree, there are giving envelopes right in front of you in the pew rack. You can take those and fill those out and hand them also to the ushers as well. I'd like to invite you to our Christmas Eve services coming up this Thursday, December the 24th, at both 5 o'clock and 11 o'clock p.m. There's nursery care provided at the 5 o'clock service only, but we trust that you can be a part of that, and we'd love to see you there. Well, folks, God bless you. Thank you for coming, and we wish you a Merry Christmas.